Tell us about how you came to be Chief Data Officer of Rio and what changes happened while you were there.
We decided, the mayor, in fact, Mayor Paes, decided how can we use all this data we are saving here, we are storing here, to build a more, a more democratic governance. We were trying to listen when the citizens were not talking straight to us. Because we have two ways, maybe three ways, to answer the citizens' needs. One is during the elections, because, mm-hmm. of course, the mayor
we're directly.
Talking. Yes,
absolutely.
Exactly. The second is asking to the citizens to talk about their problems. You can use websites or other tools or pools, etc., to understand what are the citizens' needs. But we were trying to develop a third model. So this third model, using data generated by the citizens, we were trying to build a new way to feel and to understand the needs of our cities. We were the first city in the world to sign a partnership with the Waze app. And using this information, we were able to identify the worst areas mm-hmm. in terms of traffic, to evaluate the cost of each traffic area, and also to add a social layer for accidents, for instance. Our official data were saying us that the worst area in the city was in a specific area. But according to the Wazers, the worst area in terms of accidents were not this street, but another avenue. When I show these numbers for the traffic management agency, they told me, no, you are wrong. The worst area is this other one. But I said, no, this other area is the worst according to your numbers. But according to the citizens, you may have only one accident on this other area. Mm-hmm. But this single accident may be causing a lot of
sure.
stress to the citizens.
Sure.
So you have a lot of people voting on this traffic. So you add this kind of social layer that helps a lot for the city management to understand what's happening in the city in real time with information that are not captured by other mediums as pools or etc. Before the Olympics, there are a lot of studies saying every big city loses around 8 or 10% of its GDP in traffic, mm-hmm. okay? Every big city has São Paulo, Rio, etc. Usually 8 to 10% of the productive time is lost in traffic. So what we did? We used all the social data to say, so this traffic represents 10% of all the traffic we have in the city. Mm-hmm. If the city is losing 10% of its GDP in traffic, so this area represents 1% of our GDPs. We know our GDP in Rio is 220 billion reais, so this 1% is 22 billion reais. So it allows us to say this traffic costs exactly this amount per year. So the solution cost was, let's say, 500 million, I don't know,
right.
let's say 5% GDP. Of course, in 5 years, the amount of money we would expend to fix that traffic area would be paid by the time we were giving back to the city.
The time saving more than made up
the
cost of
yes,
improving
exactly,
the infrastructure.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
This kind of analysis is very important for city planning or for thinking in a long term.
I think the main challenge to do that is that in Brazil, we don't have a lot of culture to use data, right? Mm-hmm. So one of my main challenges actually is to do graphs and to do presentations that people can understand what's going on.
Why is it so important to have good data, to have good statistics when it comes to fighting crime in a city like Rio?
So we really need to understand where crime happens. I think one of the key policies to fight crime is the hotspot analysis, and this happens because crime is concentrated, right? So we see that for all the cities in the world that people has done research, in Brazil, here in Rio, we have done research that shows that half of the street robberies happen in 3.3% of the territory, which falls within the range that people would typically find for other cities in the world. So I think it's important to see that in crime, to see very specific where crime happens, each hotspot, each corner, each street segment, you can see crime. Another thing that it's crucial to look at data, because contrary to the, any intervention you do in police, you see effects pretty fast. Mm-hmm. Basically, if you do a police intervention or any, or if you have economic crisis, any intervention that happened, any external factor, you can see effects in within 2 months, 3 months. Mm-hmm. So I think because of that, it's easier to use and to convince policymakers to look at data mm-hmm. than in other areas such as education or health. Because in education, typically, if you do an intervention, you're going to take like
years, decades
to see an effect. And I think because of that, for instance, the Secretary of Security, every month he asked me, so how are we doing? How are the statistics? Is there anything new? And I think there is very few areas within government that we can see something like that.